this could be a really, really, really bad idea, but yeah, let's see if it's possible. This video is sponsored by Grammarly. So throughout this video, I just want to be as transparent as possible and just try to be as clear with what I'm doing so that it's not vague, like I'm writing emails. So later on this month, I'm going to be bringing on a guest to this channel who I'm really excited about, and he's looking to sponsor the channel and give some stuff away. So right now, I'm composing an email which sort of outlines the budget that we'll be using and the best way to spend the money. So I'd like to give away some like YouTube starter kits for you guys, camera, microphone, memory cards, and sort of give the same opportunity that I had when I started my channel to someone else. So I'm doing some research on roughly how much that'll cost, and I'm gonna get back to them. That's what I'm working on right now. And then after that, that should be my last email of the morning. Slowly waking up. 7:31 now. I'm done with emails. Now I can start to edit. I have a little friend here. Ponyo's back inside. Currently, I'm in like the early stages of the next collection. So I'm just reaching out to manufacturers, trying to figure out colors, inspiration, and everything. I'm gonna be making some corduroy hats, and they just sent me over the Pantones, which is actually really awesome. I can show you that briefly. I don't know if you can see that. But yeah, I can go through and start to design the collection. So yeah, that's really exciting. And to be honest, I'm sort of procrastinating editing this 300K Q&A. I have so much footage to go through, like 2 hours of footage that I filmed over the course of multiple days. And I'm trying to string it together so that it tells a interesting storyline, but it's just a lot of footage to work with. And it's sort of a daunting task, so I'm procrastinating a teensy bit. My time frame to edit is slowly closing because I want to prepare for my first meeting. So I'm just going to stop talking because this is probably a form of procrastination. All right, goodbye. Goodbye. I mean it this time. I don't want to say goodbye, but I got to say goodbye. It's a hard goodbye. I'm sorry, but I really got to go. It was fun while it lasted, but I have to go. I'm sorry. Can I almost get tears out? That was close. I'm sorry. Ah, tears. Whoa, that was like, I almost manufactured a tear right there. One day when I become an actor, it'll just all trace back to this moment. All right, I gotta stop. Okay, I'm back. Basically what I'm doing right now is there's music I want to use in my video. Hey girl, what's up? She's yawning. Anyway, I don't know if it's gonna get copyrighted. Hey, what's up? You need to go pee? She just wants to go on a walk. Anyway, girl. So this girl is whining. She's whining. Girl, what's up? What do you want? Anyway, I'm uploading this to YouTube so that they scan it for me, which allows me to see if it's gonna be copyrighted or not, because I don't wanna waste my time editing the video to the music if it's just gonna get copyrighted and I can't use it anyways. So in the meantime, I'm gonna try to fly my drone out of my window, which is probably a terrible idea, but I just want to see if it's possible. The sun is like really pretty right now, so this could be a really, really, really bad idea. But yeah, let's see if it's possible.
Girl, we do not eat my drone case. Absolutely not. Let me see how to draw. Hey. You want to lick my drawing? Does that taste good? Oh, you hear that, girl? Girl, this might be a bit scary. Come on, let's go. Come on. Bye-bye.
All right. Girl, what'd I say? Hey, nope. Get out of here.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Hey. Scared. All right, if anything goes wrong, I can just grab it. This video is sponsored by Grammarly. Grammarly is a digital writing assistant that I use on a day-to-day basis, whether it's for business or for school. I'm always using it to double check or to improve upon my writing. The great thing about Grammarly is that there's a free version for everyone to use. It's super easy to download and has basic grammar and spelling suggestions. And I think there's no reason not to have that because we're human, we all make mistakes, but no one wants to send off a typo on something important for school or for work. Now, for all of you college students,
not you, dog. You don't even spell. You just want to play.
Now, for all of you college students, or honestly just anyone in general, I highly recommend that you get Grammarly Premium, and here's a couple reasons why I think it could really help you out. Grammarly Premium provides you with much more in-depth writing feedback with great features such as clarity suggestions, which help you cut down on unnecessary words to help you meet the word count in your essays and reports with clear and concise sentences. This is super helpful if you're in school, because we've all been there. There are also vocabulary suggestions, which help you expand your vocabulary, and it replaces boring or bland words with more exciting and effective words. There's also a plagiarism detector, which is also helpful if you're in school. Grammarly will check your writing across 16 billion web pages to ensure your writing is your own. Again, if you're in school, Grammarly Premium is extremely... Oh, hello! Again, if you're in school, Grammarly Premium is extremely helpful, and if you're interested, you can go to grammarly.com/max to sign up for a free account and to get 20% off Grammarly Premium today. Alright, back to the video. Girl, what? You... Worked. Let's try it again. It is 8:22. I've wasted a little bit of time with the dog and with the drone, but it's fun. I'm having fun. That's what it's all about. So I'm just gonna upload this, actually edit now, and bye.
See you!
Oh my god, she's so funny.
Are you excited?
Maybe I should come over here by you and then she'll see if she comes over. I know you always get jealous.
Yeah, you do. You get jealous. I know. Good morning. Good morning.
She's got energy.
She's got energy, right? She wants to go for a run. Yeah.
Are you going to run with her?
Nope. I am not going to run with her because I'm going to have a nice run. And then I'll come back and maybe do something.
Hey, bye, Dave. You're biting your chair. I'll take you for a walk in a bit, okay?
Oh, she'd love that. It's like so funny how her breath is so reflective of how she's feeling. I know. I would hyperventilate if I did that.
Yeah, how are you, cutie?
You're such a good puppies. Is that your way of hugging?
Are you trying to hug me? What are you doing, huh? What are you trying to do?
Hopefully you're not gonna PMX as bad as you threw up on it yesterday.
It's not funny.
I'm sorry. It's not.
It's crazy.
But your arms are so long.
All right, girl, I'll walk you after my meeting.
Ten.
Oh, that's
me. Yep. It's 9:30 now, and I've made a lot of progress on the timeline. I have a general idea of what I'm doing now. I sort of figured out the story, which was the main thing I was trying to get done today. I'll be able to edit that tomorrow morning, finish it up, and now I have a lot more clarity and direction, which feels good. I could continue working for another 30 minutes, but I need a break to like let my mind rest a bit. So I'm gonna take the next 30 minutes to just like chill, listen to some music, and maybe watch some videos on YouTube and just chill out a little bit. If I just kept on going, I would probably burn out. Yeah, so rest is just as important as working. So yeah, I'm gonna just chill. Okay, so it is 9:59. I have to create a meeting, or I'm hosting a meeting with the Perspectopia video creators team. And yeah, I'm not sure exactly how long it's gonna go on for, but yeah, it'll be nice to just catch up with everyone, plan some things moving forward with the channel, and it's an exciting feeling.
Oh
no. I'll see you guys soon. Cheers. Successful meeting. I won the Kahoot on love. We did a Kahoot at the end of the meeting just to, I don't know, have fun. And it was on love and I won. So I'm a love expert now. Max Reisinger, love expert. That's like a good resume builder. I can definitely put that on my website. I can become, I give advice on my channel here occasionally. Or not occasionally, I've been doing that more and more. But now I can start giving love advice. Next Q&A will be about love. Day in the life of a love expert. And I'll start having clients, so what's a good price? I'm not gonna say that. $100 an hour to consult about your love life. I'm very qualified. I won the Kahoot on love, so hit me up, send me an email, max@love.com. Okay, it's 11 o'clock, and I have an interview at 12, and then another one at 1, so back-to-back interviews, and then an event at 2 for the Discord. So in the meantime, I have 50 minutes to just like, and calm down a bit before I get energetic again. So I'm going to make some lunch. Just gonna make some lunch, that's it. Also, check out these glasses. Okay, so I have a question. I wasn't wearing socks all morning, but now I feel like I should put on some socks. I don't know why, but let me know if you wear socks in the house or if you go sockless. Or like sometimes I'll wear socks at night and then I'll take them off to sleep. I read a study that socks help you sleep because it keeps your warmth inside. But for some reason, I like to take them off when I sleep. I know in most cultures, you take your shoes off before you go inside. I don't know if anyone actually wears shoes inside. But I wonder if that's like a cultural thing, wearing socks inside or not. Maybe I'll ask Siri, do you wear socks inside? You don't have an answer? Siri, is it a culture?
I'm listening.
Is it a cultural thing to wear socks inside the house?
I found this on the web.
Okay, so it shows things about removing shoes, but nothing about socks. So I don't know, since there's nothing out there, let me know in the comments what you do where you're from, if you wear socks in the house or not. Check out these socks. They have like planets on them. I think they're cool. All right, time to eat. Normally, I'd be making a more elaborate meal, so I'm kind of slacking. My mom and I were watching a show last night, so we ordered some takeout sushi from our favorite place, Oishi. And yeah, that's what I'm gonna be eating for lunch. I'm just gonna take the next 20, 25 minutes to eat and to watch YouTube videos, just decompose a bit from the meeting. All right, it is 11:48. Quick dance break has been completed. I'm gonna go upstairs and meditate and then join this call.
I'm just noticing how the breath feels in the body. Remember, if you can't
feel. All right, this is the make it or break it point in every day for me. I only allow myself to work until 6 o'clock. So the first 6 hours are usually the best. My mind is fresh, it's primed, and yeah. Afterwards, you can fall into what I call the vortex, and hopefully that doesn't happen. It should be more chill because it's less demanding work, like being on a podcast, being on an interview, talking, speaking gig, whatever you want to call it. It's less demanding than editing or thinking. Yeah, the rest of the day, just interacting with people, so that'll be fun. I'm gonna just hop on this call, and hopefully the interview goes well. Wish me luck. Can you hear me? I cannot hear you. Yeah, I hear you now. Okay, so the interview went really well. That was awesome. So it's 1:44. It didn't take as long as I think or thought it would have. And in 15 minutes, we're gonna have a Discord event where I'm just gonna go on, chat, meet with people. I'm gonna go hop in a staff call for that so that we go over the safety protocols just so that everything runs smoothly. I'll probably join for like an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours. And then I'll see what the rest of the day has in store. So you guys can be in the video. You can do like a 3-2-1 hello.
Okay.
Yes.
Where am I, Christmas? And just give like a big wave in like 5 seconds. Everyone can just say hello.
Alright.
You have a count in or something?
This is a blooper and a half.
I mean, thank God for editing.
Hey.
Hi. Hi.
Just wave, it'll be awkward, it'll be fine. We tried, right? If you guys wanna be in it and you wanna like wave and say hello all at the same time, I'm gonna like cut up a little segment. Yeah. If y'all wanna be in the video.
Just tell us.
Okay, you can just wave. I'll edit it out so it's not awkward, but you can just like, hey. You can wave now.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey.
Have you ever done the spoon 360? Like this, you have to like, but you're pushing the food to your roof of your mouth and not your taste buds. Okay, so with this way, you take the food and then you... Purvis. Okay. So you take the food and you put it directly in your taste buds. So you go like this and you go... All my taste buds.
That's so smart.
So I drink like this and I... Like that.
That is super smart. That was pretty smooth.
Ow!